Hi, good morning, everyone. My name is Sinto. I'm a member of Christ Central. Today, I've been given the opportunity to share with you Mark chapter 1, verse 29, 30, and 31. Just to make it more interactive, I've asked a few people to read through, write the read through, and then I'm just going to talk through my reflection on the verse. But before we start, could we just say a prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for a new day. It's the day you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for the word we're about to read. We pray, O God, may the eyes of our understanding be enlightened to receive what you have for us, that we will understand that which your spirit is saying to us. As we share your word, as we discuss this verse, we pray, O God, that your spirit will give us insights to the understanding of the scriptures. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So if I have Femi read Mark chapter 1, verse 29, please.
Okay. As soon as they left the synagogue, they went with James and John to the home of Simon and Andrew.
Now Simon's mother-in-law was sick in bed with a high fever. They told Jesus about her right away.
So he went to her bedside, took her by the hand and helped her sit up. Then the fever left her and she prepared a small meal for them.
Thank you, my lovely readers. It was good to just hear someone read than me trying to read everything. So I think my reflection of this verse is 30. Simon's mother-in-law was sick. And they asked Jesus, she had high fever and she was in bed. So the thing that the scripture did let us know to say, was she sick for a day? If she's been sick and she's been in bed, it means that she's been sick for a long period, probably bedridden. Or it just says she's been sick with high fever. And what it says is that they asked, and Jesus went to her bedside, took her by the hands. He didn't even pray. He took her by the hands and he helped her to sit up and the fever left. I think for me, that just hits me. It's like the authority that Jesus had, that just by holding her to sit up could just radiate healing to her body, radiate healing to her spirit. And then the fever left her and immediately she stood up and she went to prepare a meal. Why did she go to prepare a meal? Why didn't she just, you know, try to check if she was okay? But that just made me feel that the sickness that she had has been a long-term sickness, because most times when you have a long illness or when you've been sick or you've been hit with something really hard, all you keep saying is that when I'm able to do the things I love to do, this is what I will do. Immediately I'm able to, you know, do what I normally do. I'm someone that is very physical. I love sports. I love dancing. And I remember when I had a back pain just a few months ago, I literally couldn't stand up from the chair. I had my husband, I had my son helping me. And it brought me to tears because it was my lowest. I had to ask people to help me do things. If I need to stand up, I had to call for help. And even when I even tried to do it, to quickly stand up, I couldn't. I was struck with sharp pain at my back. And immediately I kept telling myself, I'm like, God, when I'm able to do this, I'm just going to make sure that I run all the run that I'm able to do. And I think that's where the woman felt when she was sick. While she was in bed, she was telling herself, maybe, what does she love doing? Probably she loves cooking. And she's just saying that, if I get better, this is what I'm going to do. And for her, she's like, this is my best. This is what I love doing. And if this person has healed me, I'm going to do this for him. And that's why she stood up from her bed and to prepare a meal. And the other reflection for me is the authority that we have as Christians, as children of God. Simon, could have healed his mother-in-law because he's a follower of God. And he had that same authority as Jesus had to heal her. But he did not have faith, or he did not believe that he could be able to do it. We, as followers of Jesus, we have that same authority that Jesus had, but we just have to believe in, we just have to believe in ourselves and have that faith. It says that if we have faith as small as a mustard seed is the tiniest, little, tiniest seed you could see. If you just have that little faith, and just remember that this faith is not the faith of yours. If you just have that faith to say that, you know, this will happen. I have faith in God that this will happen. And you believe in your heart that it will happen. So there's one thing for you to have the faith. There's the other thing for you to then believe in that faith that you have. Because you can say, I have faith that I would be healed. And in your heart, you have that doubt. The doubt is going to, it's not going to help your faith. It's not going to help build up your faith to get to that level to accept the healing. So the mother-in-law had faith that when Jesus held her, she will be healed. She did not have the doubt in her heart that he didn't even pray. He held her, but she had the faith, only if he could even hold me, I will be healed. I think that's what I want to challenge all of us to say today is, if we have that faith, only if we believe. And the Bible, the scripture says in Mark chapter 16, verse 17, it says, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out devils. They shall speak in the new tongues. These signs, what are the signs? It's the signs of healing. It's the signs of casting out demons. And it's the sign to say that we are children of God. It says, greater works would we do if God did all these things back then. And he has left and he has said, we will do greater works. We should then be able to see greater things as children of God. We should challenge ourselves to say, you know, at the end of the day, who do we have to blame? It's God, right? So if you say, I'm going to pray for someone, I'm going to pray for my family member, I'm going to pray for this, you use the authority in the name of Jesus. You're not using your own name. You're using the authority in God's name. And at the end of the day, it's God. You've done what he asked you to do. He said we should pray for the sick. You have done your own bit, and you have had faith that, Lord, as I pray for this person, I believe in you, that through the authority in your name, as I pray for this person, they will receive their healing. Open your heart to accept this healing. And then you pray for them because you have done it according to his will, and he would honor his word. He will honor his word, and his word is his name. And I'll give an example. I work when I try to get things done, or I need to get things done. I send lots of emails. They wouldn't respond. Once I CC my manager, not only my manager, I CC her own manager in that same email that I've been chasing for 2 weeks. Literally, they would respond. So that's to tell you that if a human can have such authority just by their name, not even just by their email address, and they could recognize that name, that, you know, I didn't have to say she's my manager. They could recognize the name. They responded. And how be it we that have the name of Jesus? We have the name of Jesus, just mentioning it. And I think when Mark also mentioned last on Friday, he said the devil recognized that, they recognize the name of Jesus, and they know how powerful that name is. So we need to come to the consciousness that we have the name of Jesus, and we should take authority in that name, and we should speak the word. We should speak the word to say, in the name of Jesus, I receive healing. And we should use the name of God as our authority. And the devil knows that we have that power. We just need to practice what the scripture says. Thank you. So this is my reflection, and I just want us for us to just, if we're going to go into a group or we're going to stay here, it's just for us to just reflect and, you know, challenge ourselves how we can use the authority that we've been given as children of God.